Hello, I'm Laurent Grangeau, and I will speak about Istio. So this is a framework based on Kubernetes to be able to have a service mesh between microservices. So you can follow me on Twitter with a handle at Laurent Grangeau. And I'm a cloud solution architect at Sogeti, and I help customers migrating on the cloud or on Kubernetes or applying some DevOps methodology. So I've heard, so sorry for my English, I'm not a native speaker, so it will be bad, of course. But I've heard some of you, lots of you are developers, and some of you are operators, ops. And I don't know how many of you are working with microservices, but in theory, the microservices looks like that. So you have lots of services which is talking with each other. In reality, in the big four, it's more looking like that. So you have lots and lots and lots of services, and it's not possible for a human being to be able to connect these services. It's not possible for a human to be able to have some errors to be able to detect some errors. Alexis was talking about SLI, SLO, and SLA, and my talks will be an echo of what he presents. And this is where Istio come from. So Istio is a framework to connect and manage microservices on Kubernetes, and of course with virtual machines on the cloud or on-prem. Based, it has been developed by Google, Lyft, and IBM. So yes, IBM developed open source things, and it helps microservices talking to each other and DevOps methodology, for example, canary release or A/B testing. So Istio addresses many of the challenges faced by developers and operators, and to be able to have a better way to manage microservices architecture. So the concept is we have two planes, a control plane and a data plane. The data plane is composed of lots of proxies based on Envoy. So you have Envoy or Linkerd now on CNCF, so this is based on Envoy, deployed as a sidecar. And the principle is it's only Envoy that will talk with each other Envoys. So we have a diagram after. And we have a control plane, which is responsible for managing and configuring proxies in real time with YAML file and to inject some configuration at runtime. So the core components of Istio is, as I was talking, Envoy, so this is a sidecar proxy, so it's automatically injected into your pod with your running container. So it handles ingress and egress traffic between services. You have Mixer, this is a central component to enforce policy that is leveraged by the proxies. You have Pilot, which is the component responsible to configure proxy at runtime. You have Citadel, which is responsible to have mutual TLS and to be able to exchange some certificates between the proxies and to enforce the traffic and the encryption on the traffic. And you have, for example, a broker, which is a component implementing Open Service Broker API. So I don't know if you know Open Service Broker API, but it's an API to be able to pilot some external components, such as database or cloud providers, to have some external dependencies. So this is a work in progress. The architecture is looking like that. So you have all of the core components I talked about, and the communication between the proxies is an HTTP 1.1, HTTP 2, gRPC, or TCP, with or without TLS. So you can enforce TLS, with mutual TLS between proxy. And you can see that the service A and the service B in the pod can't talk to each other. The communication is between the proxy and not between the services. And so the proxy is responsible also for the policy checks and the telemetry. So we will see that in a second. So Istio enables to have some traffic management with discovery, auto-discovery, for example, rich layer 7 routing. So we have a step forward. We are not talking about layer 4 routing, but only application routing. We have some stuff like circuit breaking. If you deal with microservices and, for example, a service doesn't respond in time, so you have to implement on your code a circuit breaker. Istio can do that for you without implementing any code. So you have also policy enforcement. If you are if you use Kubernetes on a day-to-day basis, you know that you can't deny traffic between namespaces. But Istio can, because they have RBAC implementation, so we can deny some traffic between pods on different namespaces, for example. You have, of course, request tracing and telemetry recording based on open tracing, and the implementation will be, I don't know if it's Jaeger or another, but and you have also security with authorization, authentication, and rate limits and quotas. So this is important for the rate limits and quotas, because, for example, you want to be able to limit traffic from external services, because every time you call an API, it will cost you something. So you want to limit the rate on this of this call. For the traffic management, the principle is to have, for example, on the top side of this slide, in the A/B testing, canary release, based on traffic, so you can send 95% of your traffic on the service B and 5% of your traffic of the service B prime, with only a configuration of the proxy and not into your code. And on the downside of your slide, you have A/B testing based on, for example, a user agent. If it's Android, you go to the service B, and if it's iPhone, you go to the service B prime. You can also do traffic routing with cookies, for example, with the logged name, or another stuff. So as I told you, this is a zoom on how Istio works. So this is only the proxy and the envoy proxy that can talk to each other, which is configured by the pilot, and only envoy can send traffic between the service A or the service B or the service B prime. So you can do easily canary release, A/B testing, or blue-green deployment with only YAML file. You have also auto-discovering and load balancing. So every time you scale a pod, it will be auto-discovered by the pilot, and the proxy will be reconfigured at runtime, and you don't have to re-implement the ruling with some YAML file on the proxy envoy on service A to be able to load balance between the service B, the pod on the service B. So as I told you earlier, you can have some authentication, and you can deny or restrict with pilots which namespace can talk with each namespace. So for example, the full namespace can talk only with the service A, and the bar namespace can talk only with the service B. So you can't talk with, for example, the service A with the bar namespace, or the service B with the full namespace. You can enforce policy inside pilot with some YAML file, to be able to restrict or deny traffic between pods. So you have also some authentication with Citadel. Citadel is based on SPIFE, I don't know how to say that, but it's a project inside the CNCF that can do authentication and mutual TLS encryption traffic based on the service and not the IP or the DNS name. So it's only based on for example, the myorg.com/frontend/team, and they can talk to each other based on that address. So you can enforce encryption between these two proxy, and you can see that you have mutual TLS on these two services. So also Istio is have a RBAC engine, so you can allow or deny traffic between pods or services based on RBAC and also YAML. And for me, the most important part is the policies and telemetry. So you have a core component called Mixer that can be backed by lots of implementation on Bluemix, on GCP, on AWS, Prometheus, Epster, and New Relic, and also it can be extended. That implements backends like metrics, authorization, quota, or login, and that can add something that is difficult to have when you do microservices. It's the distributed tracing. So we can see that on the next slide. We have all the KPIs Alexis told you about earlier. You have some SLA, global request volume. So you have the request volume. So you have all the metrics based on Prometheus trapped by Grafana and graphed by Grafana. And also, you have an implementation of the distributed tracing, and you can see that when you call, for example, microservices, you can see all the different microservices that will be called and how long the call will take. But this is not magic. You have to implement headers, and you have to replicate headers on your code to be able to have a correlation ID from microservices to microservices to be able to have a graph like that. And the final part, you can also have some service graph, and you can represent your microservices dependency easily with some some image. So you can see that in this application, you have three different reviews. You have reviews default V1, default V2, and default V3, which is connected to rating V1 and V2. And this is automatically generated by the Istio. So this is very useful when you have to create some architecture documentation. I don't have any time left, but here is the example of the booking example we have on Istio. So this is the implementation without Istio. So you can see you have six different microservices that can talk to each other. Every one of these microservices is hosted in a pod, and if you had Istio, you can see that all of the black or brown bar is an envoy proxy, and only the envoy proxy can talk to each other and control the traffic between the microservice. And you can see that you can configure the envoy proxy on the product page to be able to talk in every version of the reviews you want. This is an example. I don't think I have time left. So if you have any questions, I will be able to answer it. Yeah.
Some few page later, you say that with distributed tracing, you can see how much time a request will make. It's very will make or is prevision or is post. You can see what time the request took, or is that prevision based on the state of the system?
No, it's the real time every call took, because you implemented some headers.
Okay.
So you can have a correlation ID passed between each microservice and correlate the duration of the call.
Okay.
So this is the real time.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Laurent, for this introduction to Istio.